Records are a new feature that was introduced in C# 9. They make it easier to create classes for holding data. So, what are records? Records are classes designed to be immutable, which means that once we create an instance, its values cannot be changed. They are defined using the record keyword, followed by the name of the record type and its properties. By declaring a record, you won't have to write as much boilerplate code, which can help simplify your code and reduce errors. A record will automatically generate a constructor. All properties listed in the record's declaration will be there. The compiler will also generate equality members, so you can safely use a record type as the dictionary key. Even such a frivolous detail as a convenient toString method will be there. Another benefit of using records is that you can use with expressions to create new instances of record types with updated values while leaving the original record instance unchanged. Each with expression will construct a new instance with only the specified members modified, so there is no fear that the change will affect any of the immutable instances. Records are often used in functional programming and can be used to implement immutable data structures and algebraic data types. Let me show you that. There can be an abstract record. Like any abstract class, an abstract record is a root for a hierarchy of record types. Other records can derive from it. And there can be other variants, too. You would probably want to avoid creating record hierarchies with more than one level of derivation. This form of a hierarchy is as close as C# has got to implementing a discriminated unions, also known as an algebraic data type in functional languages. That type represents a value that can take on one of several possible types, each with its own constructor function and pattern matching capabilities. In this example, a personal name is either a common name, a mononym, or a full name. There are no gray areas between these three definitions, and they all share the base type. We can thus represent them uniformly where needed. You see, the abstract record can still be the dictionary key. Besides these few lines I have shown, you can use records like any classes and structs. You can use them as method parameters, return types, and more. In addition to simplifying code, records can also help improve performance by reducing the amount of memory required for storing data and reducing the overhead of creating objects. Using a base abstract record type is a powerful technique for creating a family of related record types. You can define shared properties in the base record type. Any derived record type would have to initialize all the base properties, and you can declare that by passing the properties within parentheses when declaring the derived record. Of course, I must fix the instantiation point to make my code complete. But look, none of the with expressions will be disturbed by the breaking change I made in the record's definition. All properties that you omit in the initializer after the with keyword will be copied into the new instance. That still leaves it to you to include the new property in the initializer if you wish. Besides properties, records also support behavior. You can define a method on any record type, including virtual and abstract methods. Remember, a record is a class like any other. Concrete derived record types will inherit these properties and behaviors, also adding their unique properties and behaviors as desired. In conclusion, records are a powerful new feature that can help simplify your code and improve performance. By using records, you can reduce the amount of boilerplate code required to define classes for holding data. You can also create a family of related record types that share a common set of properties and behaviors. Like this video, subscribe to my channel, and watch other videos I have prepared for you. Thank you for staying with me till the very end. I genuinely appreciate that.